Hi and welcome to the fifth episode of China Tools, and the first one of this new year. And a lot has changed since the last episode. I was on holiday with my family, and during these 2 weeks I get more than 7,000 new subscribers, and I'm really very honored for that. Another thing that has happened is that Banggood sent me some products for testing. I got this very nice angle ruler and this self-centered doweling jig, and I love this doweling jig a lot, but I need some time to know all its secrets. But my first impression is that it is a very solid and nice looking product, so that looks very promising. Till my episode 4, I bought all the products I reviewed myself, and the fact that I received these products now will not change the way I make my reviews, nor will that affect my conclusions. From my experience, not everything that comes from China is a fairy tale. And that's why I started this China Tools series in the first place. I wanted to make clear which products are very good and which products you might want to avoid. And no matter how much I appreciate Banggood for sending me these wonderful products, this will not change my objective. The products that we are going to discuss today is this angle ruler that I received from Banggood. And although in my previous video I promised not to review a ruler, there is a reason why I want to talk about this ruler anyway, so keep watching. I also want to discuss two other products, and they are not very sexy, but these products every woodworker can use or need. That are feather boards and these, I don't know how they call it, angle square clamps. Let's start with these feather boards. And it's quite difficult to tell something about these feather boards. And the reason is because there are only a few different designs, and in generally they all look mostly the same. So perhaps your biggest concern should not be which one you should buy, but more how much you have to pay for them. And today I looked on Banggood and I saw an offer for only around $17. And that is a very nice price, and that was a price for a set. But prices change on Banggood due to special offers. So if you want to know what the latest price is, the best thing is to do click on one of the links in my description and check the latest price. But let's zoom in on these feather boards, because no matter how simple they are, it's a very nice product that increases the quality and safety of your cut. And if you compare that to the price, it's an item that every woodhooker should have. You mount a feather board in the miter track on your table saw, and this is very easy because of these black bars that expand when you tighten the screw. They have such a large expansion capacity that they almost fit in every type of T-track. The reach of this feather board has a max of 14 centimeters, and with some table saws that will be just too short, so check if they are long enough for your table saw. It is an ideal tool to get an accurate cut, and certainly with longer boards. The feather board ensures that the board is pressed against the fence evenly. But you can also mount them on your fence so that they press against the tabletop. Certainly when you combine two feather boards, you get a very nice accurate saw cut, and you are also protected against kickbacks. And of course, you can also use these feather boards on your router table. And if your fence is not capable for adjusting these feather boards, it's very easy to make one yourself. You just make a groove in some wood with your dovetail bit. What some may not know is that you also can turn these feather boards around, and then it is an ideal tool for cutting very thin strips. This goes really well, accurately and consistently. I have my feather boards now for a few years, and if you use them normally, they will probably last very long. So if you do not have feather boards yet, I think it's a really good investment. And with these kind of products that are almost all the same, you better can get them for the best price possible. And this This is my scorecard. If you're interested in this product or any product at all from Banggood, and you think I do a good job and you want to support my channel, please use one of my links in the description below. If they see that you have visited their site through my channel, chances are they keep supporting me with these products for reviews. Thank you for that. Ruler. The next product is this angle ruler. And as I told in my intro, there's a reason that I want to discuss this product now and not wait until a later moment. Because it's a new product on Banggood, it looks very attractive, and I can imagine that people are interested in buying it. The first thing I notice is that this angle ruler is very beautiful to see. I do not know what it is, but I found the proportions and the dimensions really nice. And I was surfing the internet and I came across this antique angle ruler on an auction. So the concept is certainly not new, but they made something very beautiful of it. The ruler has a resolution of 1 millimeter, and you can use them with a pencil of 1 millimeter either. If you look at the holes, they are very nicely tapered. But if you turn the ruler around, we see that on this side, the holes are also tapered. And if we get this ruler, you see at the back that the holes are flat. And I don't know why they did this. They may have done this because you can use them at both sides with a pencil. And if they use these flat holes, it's difficult to put your pencil in it. On the other hand, it doesn't make any sense to use these holes at the back, because you use these holes only to draw a line parallel to the top of your wood. In my view, they shouldn't have opted for this approach. If you look at a cross section of this ruler, the holes look like this. And that means that if you move the pencil back and forth, the line will move with it. If the holes at the bottom were flat, this will not happen. And it does not matter in which angle you put in your pencil, the line will be in the center. If you think this is a theoretical story, look at how big this deviation can be. Here I draw a line with a 1 millimeter pencil. I have turned the pencil to the right. If I turn it to the left, you see that there is a double line. When we do this with an 0.5 millimeter pencil, the differences are even bigger. And because of this reason, I would advise only to use the 1 millimeter pencil. Furthermore, the scale is very difficult to read on the dark black ground of this ruler. That the figures are shown in millimeter does not make that any clearer. Another strange thing is that you have to count back if you want to use the millimeter holes. If you look at the scale at, for example, 18 millimeter, if you would follow the holes, they run downwards, so we have to count back. And also we have to read from right to left, what we are not used to do. If they had made the ruler this way, the figures will go up and we would also read from left to right. It is an angle ruler, so you must be able to turn the ruler in different angles. And here the scale is also difficult to read. The lines are also too small in my view. The dimensioned angles are 80, 60 and 40 degrees on both sides. And I find it a bit strange that such an important angle as 45 degrees is not indicated. But if you have to succeed in finding the right angle, I have to say it's accurate. If you use the rear side, you will notice that there is no scaling. And I think it would be nice if they had put also a scale on here. The last thing I can report is that if you adjust an angle and you want to draw a line, this button to tighten it gets in your way. You cannot use it on a flat table, at least not with a board with a thickness below 20 millimeters. You can see that this ruler has a few shortcomings. That is the reason why I did not want to wait with this review, because it's a very cool thing to see, and it's a pity that a number of points have not been just a little bit better, because at the end that would make a world of difference. So if you're interested in buying this product, you have to look careful if you can live with the shortcomings I mentioned. And this is my scoring card. Because it is a really nice ruler, I experimented a bit how to make it better, and with these easy modifications you make this ruler a lot more easier to use. Now we can use it on a flat table, we can adjust the angle without flipping the ruler over, and we have a scale when we want to draw a line with an angle. So I hope Banggood will still send me some products after they see this review. The last product I want to talk about are these clamping squares. And these are among one of the most used products in my workplace. Primarily, they are a very nice tool to connect two boards together at an angle of 90 degrees. And they do that very easy and very precise. I have more products with which I can do that. I like these Bessie clamps. And I also have these corn clamps that I also bought on Banggood. But those two alternatives are more expensive and have only one very specific purpose. And these angle clamps can be used for many more applications. They are ideal for aligning work pieces during assembly work, but I also use them a lot when I have to glue two pieces together and it should be on 90 degrees. I like to press it first before I use clamps. And with these products, it ensures that I have the right angle and it doesn't shift when I put pressure on them. But I also use them as a jig to align two boards when they need to be on an exact angle of 90 degrees. These clamp squares come in various designs and I like this one the most.
What I like particularly is that you can screw them on a board. And this is very helpful when you want to make a few drawers, for example. This way you can very easily make a small series that is consistently and fast. But also when you make drawers with a pocket hole, for example, now you can very easily put them together without having worried the pieces shift when you assemble them.
I think you need at least two of them, but you probably end up with four, because you do need this number regularly. And I made a mistake to buy two and later buy some more from another brand because of the price. And they look very similar, but they differ a little bit from dimension. And sometimes that is a problem. So my advice would be to immediately buy two or four of the same version to guarantee that you have the same dimensions. It's a really nice product and I think every woodworker needs it. And although my preference goes to this kind of square, you can't go wrong with another one either. And this is my scoring card. Well, that was the fifth episode of China Tools. I hope you like it. I would really appreciate if you use the links in my description below to enter their sites. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and I'll see you next time.